Hi, in this tutorial I will show you how to integrate a 3D object into a video clip with shadow casting. This is not a tracking tutorial, so I will do this as fast, rough and dirty as possible. You find tons of tutorials out there about this topic. Switch to the motion tracker layout and load your footage. Set the resampling to 100%. I create auto tracking points in the first and last frame and somewhere in the middle and let Cinema4D do the job. Switch to the 3D Solve tab and run the 3D Solver. Next, create a planar constraint on your motion tracker and choose some of the green tracking points on the ground. Just drag the triangle points onto the tracker points. In the attributes, you will see the selected tracker points. Next, create a position constraint and this will set the selected tracking point to position 0. This makes it a lot easier when importing and placing your objects. Just import or create any kind of object you want to have in the scene. Now we will set up the scene itself. Create a plane for the ground and a new render material. Select your video footage and activate Animated and use Source Resolution. To get shadows, we need to create a light source first. I don't want the floor plane to be influenced by the light sources, so I add a compositing tag on it and set it to compositing background. But now our shadow disappears. To bring it back, you have to create a background object and just copy the U-Render material on it. Be sure that the background object is located below the floor object in the Object Manager. Now you can set up the materials and render settings you need. For the best results, you should use an HDR image of your recorded location, but that's not always possible. In many cases, you would need to find one that matches your setting as close as possible. You also can use a very slight amount of bloom and other effects like vignette or chromatic aberration to unify the look of the 3D content and the video together. The result is better if you put more time into the tracking process. But I think this example should give you an idea how easy these kind of tasks are with Cinema4D and U-Render. Thanks for watching.